नित्यानन्देश्वर परमशिवसमारम्भाम् नित्यानन्देश्वरि पराशक्तिमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम् वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis, shrimahans, mahans, tanedar, kotari, visitors, viewers, sitting with us all over the world through Nityananda TV and two-way video conferencing, YouTube Live, Facebook Live, Enlighten App, Kailasa TV, Hinduism Now, Twitter and two-way video conferencing, having Naina Diksha. I welcome you all with my love and respects. When you understand the whole world is orderly, it may be intense but not chaos, you get grounded, so grounded, while you are alive, you feel liberated. Listen carefully. I feel the whole world is too small word. I should say that whole existence, cosmos, universe, prapancha is so orderly. Everything is absolutely orderly. Understand? Right, wrong, good, bad, the dualities does not need to make you powerless. The existence of the external dualities does not need to create dual reactions from inside you. That is what I am trying to tell you. Understand? I am not saying the evil does not exist outside. I am saying your inside does not need to have powerless reactions. And I am not saying evil exists outside. I am not saying evil exists or not exists. I am only saying whether it exists or not, it is irrelevant for your existence. I tell you, this extraordinary grounding Arunagiri Yogeshwara gave me with his tremendous love made me extremely integrated and very grounded. Listen. Not being grounded is one of the worst suffering modern day humanity is facing. That is why so much of revolt, anger against everything. It's not that people are angry with some political system, economical system, religious system. Everywhere I am seeing people are angry about everything because one of the important thing the modern day humanity is missing is teaching the children to be grounded, understand? Only after I grew up, I feel grateful to my gurus. The way they grounded me with my integrity. Whether yoga or puja or the right powerful cognitions, the way they grounded me, something extraordinary. I can see same my age boys who grew up in Thiruvannamalai. Now, this autobiography team, it's going and collecting material from all of them, talking to them, interviewing all of them. I can see the way they are now and the way I am now. The difference, the only difference is Arunagiri Yogeshwara grounded me. The extraordinary love and integrity. I tell you, it is not that because he showered love, he did not integrate me. It's not love of spoiling. The modern day parents, when they can't spend time with you, when they can't groom you, train you, be around you, they just give you gifts in the name of love. You also equate gifts to love and love to gifts. This whole habit of gifts is an absolute stupidity. It's a cunning way parents cheat the kids. When you can't spend time with them, groom them, integrate them, in the name of gifts, cheating them. I tell you, I'll really have to tell you. Understand? My gurus gave me love which made me integrated. Like yesterday I was telling about Ma Annamaya in Madurai, SSJP. I had one Annamaya in my life. My grandmother, my father's mother, her name is Anusuya. Absolute integrity. The last day she died, she went to temple without missing her routine. Understand, going to temple from home, coming back, she cooked on her own. She lives on Swayambhaga. You see, in Indian tradition, the widow, after husband passes away, women live a very austere life. I have seen. She is the ideal widow. My father's father passed away even before my father's marriage. She is a young widow. I think maybe my grandmother became widow before even 30. Before she was 30, she became widow. The absolute ideal Hindu chaste widow's life I have seen in her. How traditional Hindu widows live, dedicating their whole life to spirituality and enlightenment. I have seen her living that life all by herself. She brought up all the three kids. Of course, it's a joint family. Means like a whole family supports. She had an elder brother. whose daughter is my mother, and another one brother. All three lived as a joint family, practical joint family. But the way she completed her responsibilities, extreme integrity, inside family, it is not that there will not be any problems or confusions or fights. My mother used to be terrorized by my grandmother. But nothing touched her spiritual integrity and life. Neither her religious practices, nor her spiritual practices, nor her spiritual activities. She lived absolute, devoted, a Hindu sannyasini life. A devoted sannyasini, or Rudraganya, how she will live? My grandmother lived that life. I should actually say, apart from managing her life and her kids, she will go every day, spend time with Mata Vibhudanandapuri Kuppammal. Not only she will go to street, shop to shop, collect small, small donations, do social service activities like Annadan. She will be so highly integrated to that money, she will not even bring that money to the home. She will keep in the Kuppammal's house itself. All activity will be done there itself. And all money will be spent. Accounts will be properly maintained. And all the donors will receive the prasadam. Extremely integrated. If I can create this kind of a extremely integrated people, nobody can push her. She's an elderly lady. She can one day rest without going to Thiruvannamalai temple, Arunachaleshwara temple. No. Never she will miss going to the temple and doing all her rituals. Not only that, she had her own managing system. How she will manage the temple officials and workers, staff. All the low-level staff, she will tip them. Through that, she will have a complete eye on the temple administration and make sure nobody cheats. If somebody cheats or misses the integrity, it's not that she will fire or scream or shout. She will very friendly way talk to his wife or his brother, through whom he should be advised or educated. She had her own network. She had her own network of friends, family, through whom she will reach out to that person and say, "Hey, Annamalai yaar paavanda, venanda. Paru, kovil maattukku avathikkira varalennu solranga paru. Adellam sariya panittadanda oor nalla irukum, odambu nalla irukum, pulla kuttinga nalla irukum." Means she will send the message to them. Do not disturb the temple services. Only if all the temple services happens properly, the village will be flourishing and the children will be happy. The way she sends the message, it is too strategic. She will not straight away involve. I learned the strategical way of making people integrated from her only. She will not make people angry. She will not directly confront them. She will remind to them through right persons. She is literally right hand of Kuppammal. That is why the Kuppammal had a small organization. I should not say small. It's a maybe volume wise small, but the effort Kuppammal put a whole life. That organization is called Abhidhagusambal Tiruppugal Sabai. It's fundamentally to promote the Shakta tradition and Arunagirinathar's Tiruppugal on Subramanya Swami. You can see my grandmother and Kuppammal both. It's on exactly on that same Paramashiva Parai on which I became enlightened, on that same Shila. Only three people sat on that Paramashiva Parai. One is Kuppammal, my guru Vibhudanandapuri, and my grandmother Anusuya Ammal, and me. Only three have sat ever on that Paramashiva Parai. That Kuppammal's organization, she was president, and my grandmother Anusuya Ammal was vice president. Very extremely organized. One integrated person is equivalent to $100 million, I tell you. See, Kailasa economy is different. This does not function by currency of the country, nation. Even if we get $1 billion, what are we going to do? We are not going to do anything. We are not going to open a Las Vegas casino or club, no. $1 billion has no use for us. If we have one integrated person, he will be 1,000 times more useful for Kailasa than $1 billion. Because fundamentally, we need people who will evolve, train beings in enlightenment science. Understand, I am telling you again and again. If you think money made Kailasa, you are fool, you are stupid. You are like Ravana who tried to take the Kailasa to Sri Lanka. Stupid fellow. Kailasa is a space. Fall at the feet of Paramashiva and dissolve into him. Become one with him. Kailasa opens up where you are. Integrity is the way to get the Kailasa where you are. Getting grounded in deep love makes you manifest integrity. I tell you, Arunagiri Yogeshwara gave me extraordinary love. With that love, he integrated me. He never spoiled me. Whenever I show love, whoever tries to become integrated, I have showered more love on them. When they try to possess me, abuse me, demand me to spoil them, I say, no, that is not right. That's not integrity to my guru. I'll shower me on you. If you become integrated, I'll shower more and more. If you try to be stupid, try to demand me, try to demand that I should support your stupidity, unchastity, cheating, non-integrity behavior, no, that will not work with me. Actually, if you pump love energy, love of the guru into your consciousness, you will become grounded and integrated. Love of the guru makes you grounded and integrated. I tell you, Arunagiri Yogeshwara made me so grounded. I just know I have no death. There's no such thing as death. Understand? The quality of love is it makes you feel you are going to be here forever. If you want to check whether you are in love with somebody, whether you are in love with somebody or you are in love with your Ishtadevata, God, or you are in love with your Guru, whenever you are in love, the first thing you will experience is you will feel like eternal. That Lala internal music, it will give you the strength you are going to be eternal. I tell you. That ecstasy of love, you are going to be eternal. Yesterday, yeah. Sent a message saying that she suddenly experienced extraordinary silence and only the Mahavagya chanting was going on in my voice. I want to tell her, Visiri Swamigal, Yogi Ramaswaratmar gave me this experience when he blew his smoke on my face. He gave me that experience of anahata, means this external ordinary sounds have stopped completely. They disappeared. It's called anahata dvani. Extreme silence. And no man-made sounds can be heard. Only Mahavagya. I tell you. All these experiences grounds you in the eternal feeling. I tell you, if you feel very grounded, very powerful, you feel like I am going to be here forever. Whenever you feel I am going to be here forever, be very clear, you are in love. Love grounds. The real gift you will get from Guru is love which really grounds you. I tell you, my Guru's love for me grounded me. My grandmother Annamaya, like Annamaya. Her name is Anusuya. Her extreme integrity. Actually, because she herself is so integrated, when she wakes me up for morning yoga or sending me to be with Raghupati Yogi for yoga, I never got angry because I saw, can you imagine, I don't know which year she, at what age she passed away, surely she lived quite a long time. Last day of the death, she goes to temple as usual, without reducing her speed. She is known for walking fast. And she will go around the whole hill regularly, 14 kilometers. That is part of her everyday ritual, everyday routine. She goes to temple, does her usual girivalam, comes back, cooks and eats and calls somebody from the family and tells that she is having a chest pain, she may die, and informs them to inform me. I was in Bangalore that time. She tells them, please inform Swamiji that I should reach his feet, whatever happens, and then makes coffee for herself. She used to enjoy coffee. In Tamil Nadu, there is a filter coffee, that special coffee, Narsu's coffee, they call it, Narsu's filter coffee. She makes coffee for herself, drinks, tells everyone, blesses everyone, and just lies down, passes away. Over. No fuss, nothing, nothing. Just passed away in sleep. Actually, after she lied down, telling everyone she's going to leave the body, for half an hour, the pulse, everything was normal. So they thought she may be sleeping, and then she will get up after 1 hour. She will become all right. Maybe she is a little hallucinating, or all that these guys are talking. But by the time I received the news and I relaxed in Samadhi and I saw she is connecting with me, and she left the body, and I woke up and said that bring doctor and check party pulse. By the time doctor came and checked the pulse, they said she left the body. She passed away. I went and personally did all the rites and did Samadhi for her in our Adhinam. She's having Samadhi in our Adhinam next to my father's Samadhi. What an integrity. I wanted to tell all the brahmacharis and everyone in the Shyamala Pita Sarvanga Pita, you guys will not understand or appreciate Annamaya's sacrifice for all of you now. Once you all become well built, healthy. See, I am 40. The way I am sitting and the way you guys are sitting, the way I sit for hours and the way you guys are sitting, the way I am sitting is because of my gurus made me integrated. I did not have conflict with my gurus. If at all you guys come to conflict free life with Annamaya and live for 1 or 2 years and make your body yogic body and yogic mind, evolve in completion and spirituality, one day you guys will appreciate, oh God, what a sacrifice Annamaya did. In the modern day, there is nobody to care for others. Understand that. Nobody is interested in others. Everybody is only interested in themselves. What is this elderly lady Annamaya is going to gain from all of you? If she says, Swamiji, I am not able to control these boys, they are not ready to be integrated, I am going, if she throws the tantrum, then I will say, what can I also do? I will say, okay, all right, go to ladies branch and be like other women. It's not that all the women stand up for me. No, even my own daughters whom I brought up don't stand for integrity. See the dedication of Annamaya. If you guys live a conflict-free life with Annamaya and learn integrity, each one of you will become like $100 billion worth asset for the world. I am already 40. I can sit in Bhatmasana, Artha Bhatmasana, Yogasana, Vajrasana comfortably 18 hours without bending the back, straight, with absolute completion. Once I sit in this pose, directly I am downloading from Kailasa and speaking. Nothing touches me. I don't even remember people trying to abuse me or Sangha. I don't even remember them. I don't remember the attackers, abusers, people who try to assassinate. I don't remember any of them. I am just complete with Kailasa and downloading Kailasa and radiating. Completion with body. Completion with mind. Absolute grounding is achieved by integrity. All the Shyamala Peta, Sarvanga Peta Yuvarajas, you should know, to wake you up morning for yoga, she also has to wake up. In our age, how many of you will wake up every day morning? Let's see. In our age, if you guys are alive without broken mentally, bipolar or loose, that itself will be great. Not only she is active, alive, dedicated. She says, Swamiji, I am dedicated to the integrity of all these boys, all these Yuvarajas. And one great thing is she has no anger. She has no violence. She is absolutely dedicated. That is why, because she has no violence only, you guys are not able to break her. If she has even little violence, I know how you guys can play games and break. When I saw my grandmother's integrity, I decided to become integrated. Every day going to temple, only blessed people will get that opportunity. Understand? We have a place right outside Madurai, our border of the Madurai, Maitreyi Solai's family gave. But after we got that property, only I bought this property, this Shyamala Peta Sarvanga Peta. I bought this property just because I want Yuvarajas to learn the habit of going to temple every morning. And I am also buying one more property just next to Thiruvannamalai temple. Already the negotiation is going on. In few days we will be buying. Because I want one batch of Yuvarajas and Yuvaranis to stay in Madurai and go to temple every day. Same way, one batch of Yuvarajas and Yuvaranis to stay in Thiruvannamalai and go to temple every day. Learn integrity. Understand? This one habit, going to temple every morning, doing Anmartha Puja, doing my yoga, and then my spiritual practices of power manifestation, whatever, whatever. One person integrated to this lifestyle is equivalent to $100 billion in Kailasa economy. Because even if somebody gives me $100 billion, I'll only going to be spending it on producing more and more integrated people. People who feel integrity as they are breathing. Not that, oh, I have to do yoga 7 o'clock. I just came 7:05, 7:10. What is wrong in it? No. Seriously, something is wrong in it. With integrity, yoga becomes power manifestation process. Without integrity, it becomes just a body bending or bodybuilding exercise. Gym, ordinary gym. You may have little muscles and little health. With integrity, sincerity to integrity, integrity to authenticity, authenticity to integrity, yoga becomes power manifestation process. Once you know you have to keep integrity to time, then you will start keeping integrity to the principle. Then you will start keeping integrity to the space. I tell you, the earliest you come to integrity, better for you and your future. Go on detoxing your body and mind till you become absolutely integrated. Guru's love grounds you, makes you integrated, makes you feel you are going to be here for eternal. So many ashrams, temples, sarvajna peethas. Everywhere, when I see puja happening, especially during the mandala process, the materialization happening, people having darshans, all this just because of integrity, understand? All of you understand, when you go to a temple, remember, gods are manifesting in the deities. Our ancestors, rishis, they know how to make gods birth as deities. Gods don't have birth death, but our ancestors know how to make the god manifest as deities. Again and again, bringing integrity to the words you utter empowers you, makes you manifest multiple powers. Kailasa functions in the space of integrity. Anybody wants to be part of the Kailasa should make integrity as their life. I have seen, with integrity, you will see miracles in the life. Life is miracles. Logic of super consciousness is integrity. Guru's love grounds you and evolves you in integrity. Understand, Guru's love gives you such extraordinary trust on life even when devotees asked me Swamiji how can Kalabhairava allow your body to be poisoned I tell you really I did not even have that question towards Kalabhairava I told the devotees hey how do we know his great plans are he has not allowed me to die not only he has completely healed me detoxed me he has given me the gift of this great kayakalpa signs to live as long as I want understand how do we know the great plans of Paramashiva this kind of a grounding please listen carefully missing link of your logic is not confusion or chaos it is magic if you have a trust and grounded on Paramashiva understand because I am grounded in Paramashiva any missing link comes in front of me only I feel like a magic of Paramashiva I don't feel that as oh some problem chaos confusion no I know it is magic it's Paramashiva's work maybe next few hours or few days few weeks I will know why he did what he did but I am not interested in questioning him I'll be a chaste disciple he will reveal when needed to be revealed this is today's powerful cognition listen the essence of today's satsang powerful cognition Guru's love grounds you and grows you in integrity. I want all of you to have darshan of my gurus. See, all my gurus who supported me, groomed me, evolved me, I've collected now all their photographs. Thanks to autobiography team, Ma Bhaktikananda and her team. They have collected everyone and organized it and uploaded. I think they uploaded in the Facebook page as a biography album. I want all of you to enjoy that album. Today, enjoy that album. Thoroughly read. I think some 200 slides they have put. I don't know exact number. Maybe 200 or less than 200. Read and enjoy everything and share with the whole world. Maybe 200 photos or 100 slide, something like that. I don't know the exact number, you watch. But they have collected 128 slides. They have collected almost all my gurus, teachers, acharyas, inspirations, their photographs. How each one supported me, groomed me, evolved me, raised me. From my father, I learnt giving, charity, giving, giving, giving. From my mother, I learnt non-wasting. Even now, if my mother is in one ashram, I know in that whole ashram, nothing will be wasted. Non-wasting and protecting. What a person. Symbol of a chaste woman. Non-wasting. my grandmother had one heart attack, and then I brought her to the hospital in Bangalore, and we did all the medical care. After that, before going, she asked in Tamil. She said, "Sami selavu panni enak vaidyam ellam paathirukku na inge irundhu ashramathukku edha seva panni andha kadan kalicha thana nalladhu." I laughed and told her, "Go and have darshana of Arunachaleshwara every day. That is the best way you will pay the debts back to me." And Sangha. No, I just can't imagine the sincerity. What they have done to my life. And they don't feel they have done to my life and they have a right to be taken care by the Sangha. They feel, no. If actually I asked my father, "Can I give you one car? Because I heard you are going by walk from home to the office where he was working. He was employed till the end. He was receiving monthly salary of less than 1,000 rupees till the last day of his life. 1,000 rupees whole month salary, not per day salary. Month salary was less than 1,000 rupees. Because of his pattern of giving, nothing else. He never cheated anyone. He is a giver. I asked him that, "Can I give a car for you?" He touched my feet and said, in Tamil he said, "Kadasi varaikkum Sami kitta irundha aashirvaadam thavara vera edhuvum naanga vaangalendra nalla peroda sethu poirunu Sami." He told in Tamil, "Till the last, I should have the good name from Swamiji. We took only blessings, nothing else. With that good name, we should die." And he died the same way. I said, "Tathastu." Same way he died. Never took anything from me. I could not even do medical care for him because it was sudden cardiac arrest and he passed away. At least for my grandmother, I could do little medical care. Even for that, she was asking, what kind of people, oh God. The stamina, maturity of life. I want all of you to see all my guru's photos today and share with the whole world. So today's essence of satsang is guru's love grounds you and raises you in integrity. With this powerful cognition, share the biography album to the whole world. And now sit with this one powerful cognition. Guru's love grounds you and raises you in integrity. Sit with this one powerful cognition.
Paramashivoham.
Om Nityananda Paramashivoham.
Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda Paramashivoham. Om Nityananda शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ 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 नित्यानन्द आनंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम ओम नित्यानंद परम शिवोहम परम शिवोहम् ओम शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
Nityananda
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
Yeah.
शिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम् ॐ नित्यानन्द परमशिवोऽहम्
I bless you all. Now start doing power manifestation. And I also wanted all of you to know in the next few days I am going to be teaching more and more deeper and deeper power manifestation techniques and processes. Today share this album of all my gurus to the whole world. My blessings to all of you. Let's all radiate with integrity, authenticity, responsibility, enriching, causing, living Shuddhadvaita Saivam, Paramashivoham, the eternal bliss, Nityananda. Thank you. Be blissful.